Okay, this is the exterior part three. I'm just coming along where we started here at the stairs. Just these gaps in the wood. Should just fill those gaps, get a good coat of paint on that so water can't get in between the boards. Yep, the same thing on this side is the wooden trellis, wood to ground contact. The bottom board here, almost every single one has some degree of wood rot. The board is very spongy. Right here, this board, it wasn't painted on the end, so you got a little cracking, a little moisture damage. This is a good place to see the wood. You can see the damage of the wood behind there. This is your main water supply. And this is your sprinkler backflow protector. The siding on this side looks good. You do have the same issue with the buttress joints in different places. Coming through the front gate. These bushes are cut away from the wall and from the stairs. Same thing on this side. So that's great. You want to keep those trimmed back. These trees are beginning to spread out a little bit. This one is almost up on the column on the front porch. And same thing with this one over here. You want to keep those trimmed back 3 to 5 feet. If these become trees, they're way too close to the house. Maybe I'll start thinking about that before they're super big. The brick up here looks good. Walk up the stairs here. The locks and the handles out here are they're just damaged from the rain, from constant moisture. The locks, maybe you could get one of those locks that has the covers. They're pretty stiff when you put the key in. The columns look good. The columns are directly on the wood deck, so you want to make sure you keep those sealed with caulking all around the base of that so that so moisture can't get underneath. The deck up here looks great. Got a few gaps, a few scuffs. Just want to keep those sealed with paint. And that is it for the exterior.